Hi everyone, welcome you all. This is Pawan. In the today's video, I'm going to show you how we can work with the directory commands. So there are three commands are available. One is mkdir and cd and then rmdir. So basically mkdir is a command by which we can create a directory or subdirectories. And by using cd command, we can change the directory. That means we can navigate between multiple directories. And rmdir, so by using this command, we can remove the directory or we can remove the subdirectories. Now we will see practically how we can use these three commands, mkdir, cd and rmdir. Now let's go to Ubuntu. And here I'm just logging into my Linux. All right, so now I'm just opening my terminal. And this is my Unix terminal. So let me just increase the size. Okay. All right. So the first command is mkdir. Now, before that, let me just execute one command called ls, which will list out all the files and directories. Now I'm going to create a new directory. So to create a new directory, or we can say make directory, we can just execute one command called mkdir. Let's say mkdir, which will make a directory, and I'll give some name of the directory. I'll say testdir. So mkdir, which will make the directory, and the name of the directory is testdir. Now enter. Now after execution of this command, just say ls. Now we can see testdir, which is a new directory which is created. And similarly, we can also create multiple directories at the same time. So I want to create three different directories on the same folder or same directory. So then how we can do that? We can simply say mkdir. I'll say testdir1 and say testdir2 and I'll say testdir3. So test directory 1, test directory 2, test directory 3. So three directories I'm going to create in current directory. So we can create multiple directories at the same time and just enter. Now which is creating three directories. Now we can just list out here. You can see test directory 1, 2 and test directory 3. So three directories have been created. And similarly, we can also create subdirectories. Suppose let's say A1 and inside this A2 or inside this A3, something like this. We can create multiple subdirectories at the same time. So for that, we can use command called mkdir. And additionally, we have to use one option called -p. So mkdir -p. Now I want to create a new directory, let's say world. Inside this directory, I want to create one more subdirectory, I'll say countries. Inside this directory, I want to create another subdirectory, we'll say states. Now world is a parent directory. Inside this, countries is another directory, subdirectory. Inside the countries, states is another subdirectory. Now it is created multiple subdirectories. Now if I want to just look at this ls, now world is created. Now if you want to see what are the other directories which is created in the world, we can just change the directory. Cd, I say world, and now we can say ls here. Now it is there, countries. And if you want to see what is there inside the countries, again change the directory. Cd countries, go to countries directory. Now I'll say ls. Now I can see states. So currently, where are we? We are in print the working directory, present working directory. So here, home, Pawan, world, countries. So inside the countries, we have a states. So we have a states here. So it is created multiple subdirectories. Okay, so mkdir is a command by which we can make a directory or we can create a new directory. We can create multiple directories and also we can create multiple subdirectories. Now I'll show you how to use cd command. So basically cd command used to change or closing the directory. So for example, here currently I'm just printing my current working directory. I'll say pwd. So pw means print working directory. So when I execute pwd, which is printed exactly which directory currently I am. Right? Inside the home, Pawan, world and countries. So this is my current directory. So I want to just go back to my previous directory. Okay, I want to just go to the parent directory of countries, that is a world. Now how we can go back is we can simply say cd space dot dot. So when I say cd space dot dot, and this particular command will go to the parent directory of the countries. So currently we are in countries, and what is the parent directory of the countries is world. Now when I say cd space dot dot, which will go to the parent directory. Now we are in the parent directory. Now if I execute once again pwd command, now it is showing world. So this is our current directory. So cd dot dot is a command which will go back to one level, or it will go to parent directory. So for example, I want to go to the home directory. So for example, here I'm in world directory. I want to go to the root directory. So for example, let me just again go to countries directory. So cd countries. Okay, now I'm in countries. I'll say present in the countries, the state is also there. So cd states. Okay, now I enter into the world, countries and states. If I just look at this present working directory, so this is my present working directory. Now if you want to just go to the parent directory one level back, then use cd space dot dot. And suppose I want to go to the home directory, that's my root directory. Directly I want to jump to my root directory. So then we can use one command called cd tilde symbol. So td tilde. So this command will automatically move to home directory. So wherever you are, will directly go to the root directory or home directory. So the cd tilde symbol. So when I execute this, now it went to home directory. Now we say present working directory, which is giving home directory location. So by using cd command, we can change the directories and we can navigate between multiple subdirectories. And we can also go to the parent directories. We can also navigate to the parent directories. So cd space dot dot will go back to the one level, and cd tilde symbol, which will go back to the home directory. And if you want to enter into some directory, let's change the directory. So then you can say cd, you can specify the directory. For example, let's say ls, I have something called world here. So I want to go to the world directory. I can simply say cd world. Now currently we are in world. When I say ls again, which will show you what are other files or directories available in this world. So cd command we can use in three different ways. If I use only cd command, we can change the directory. And when I say cd space dot dot, which will go to the parent directory. When I say cd tilde symbol, which will go to the home directory. Okay. Now there is one more command called rmdir, remove directory. Suppose if you want to remove the existing directory, I can use rmdir. But here rmdir will remove the directory only if the directory is empty. That means it should not have any files or subdirectories, and then only rmdir will be able to remove the directory. So for example, let me just clear the screen and let me go back to my parent directory, cd space and tilde symbol. Now present working directory is home Pavan, and clear the screen and ls. Now if I just look at this, I want to remove the directory. Okay, so for example, here I have a testdir, so it doesn't have any subdirectories. I can directly remove it. I'll say rmdir and testdir, so which will remove the directory. And if I just ls, and previously testdir was there, now it is not there in this list. So directory is removed because this is empty directory. Now I'm trying to remove the world directory, because which is also contains some subdirectories, world, countries and states. So now I want to remove this. So let's see what is an error we will get. So I'll say rmdir, say world. Now you can see rmdir failed to remove world directory because it is not empty. So that is a problem with rmdir. If the directory is empty, then only we can delete the directory by using rmdir. But still I want to delete the directory even though which is having folders or subdirectories or files. So then we can use rm command. rm -r, and I say world. So this is the alternative command we can use. So rm command we can use to remove the files as well as directories. But rmdir also we can remove the directory, but if the directory should be empty, in that case rmdir will remove the directory. Now, even though the directory contains the subfolders or subdirectories or files, then still if I want to remove that, I can simply say rm-r world. Now this is removed. Now when I say ls, now you can say world is removed here. Okay, and by using rmdir, we can also remove multiple directories. So for example, I say testdir1, testdir2, testdir3. So I have three different directories which are empty. Inside these directories, I don't have any subdirectories or files. So I can remove all of them at once. So simply say rmdir, and I'll say testdir1 space testdir2 and space testdir. I think spelling is mistake. T-E-S only there. So I say testdir3. So you can specify any number of directories list like this, and which will remove all the directories at once. But again, the same rule is applicable. So these directories should not have any subdirectories or subfiles. So now enter, all the directories have removed. Now when I say ls, and all the directories have been removed. Okay, so this is how we can use these three commands: mkdir, cd, and rmdir. Mkdir will make the directory, or will make the subdirectories, or will make the multiple directories. Cd command will change the directories, and rmdir will remove the directory if it is empty. Okay, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.